Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up your invoices, sales receipts, and estimates, also called sales forms in QuickBooks. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. It's important to set up your invoices, sales receipts, and estimates because the selections that you make here will affect when your customers pay you. This is also where you'll account for any discounts that you provide to customers and deposits received from customers. This is one of those areas that can cause negative cash flow if it is not set up properly. In this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing to illustrate some concepts. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. After you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the gear icon located right to the left of your company name and select Account and Settings directly below your company. Click on the Sales tab on the left and scroll down to the Sales Form Content section. To edit a field, just click on the pencil icon located to the far right. The first field that we want to edit here is Preferred Invoice Terms. Preferred invoice terms allow you to set up default payment terms for all customers. For example, setting default payment terms of net 30 here would mean that your customers' invoices are due 30 days from the invoice date. Setting up default invoice terms will save you time so that you don't have to set up payment terms for each customer separately. However, if you do need to set up special payment terms for a customer, you can do so when you create the customer in QuickBooks. Just click this link to watch our lesson on setting up customers, where we walk you through how to set up special payment terms in the customer profile. You can also learn more about choosing the right payment terms for your customers by clicking this link. Preferred delivery method. Preferred delivery method allows you to set up a default for how you will send your customers their invoices. The options here are print later, which means you will print and mail the invoice, or send later, which means that you will send the invoice via email to your customers. Paul prefers to save as many trees as possible, so he will set the default here to email his customers their invoices. However, a handful of customers also prefer to receive a mailed invoice copy. Similar to payment terms, you can select special delivery method option when you set up your customers. We cover this in our Setting Up Your Customers video tutorial, which you can watch by clicking this link. The next field that we want to edit is shipping. This feature is applicable only if you are shipping product. If so, then this feature will add shipping fields like ship date, tracking number, ship to address to your sales forms. Custom fields. If you need to add any additional information in QuickBooks, but there is no place to put it, then you can create a custom field by turning this feature on. As you can see, Paul has one custom field created called order number. This information will appear on his sales form. Paul would like to create another custom field called customer ID. He has assigned a customer ID to each of his customers and would like to keep track of this for internal purposes only. Custom transaction numbers. QuickBooks allows you to use your own numbering system for invoices, sales receipts, and estimates. This can be beneficial to a business that is converting from another bookkeeping system and wants to keep the same numbering system that it currently has in place. Otherwise, don't worry about turning this feature on. QuickBooks will automatically assign transaction numbers for you. Service date. This will add a service date field to all sales forms if you need to track date of service separately from the invoice date. Typically, a business that provides consulting services may want to use the service date field to provide the date the consultation took place on their invoices. Paul definitely likes to keep track of service dates. Since he cannot bill a customer until he completes a job, it is important for him to keep track of how long it takes him to invoice a customer for a job from the date of service. Discount. If you plan to give your customers a discount on the products or services that you provide, then you will need to turn this feature on to add a discount field to all invoices. This will ensure that your customer can see on their invoices any discounts that you have applied. Click on this link to read our article about when and how to provide discounts to your customers. Deposit. If you typically require a deposit from customers prior to doing any work, then you should activate this feature so that a deposit field can be added to an invoice form. QuickBooks will subtract the deposit from the total amount of the invoice to calculate the balance due. In the plumbing business, you've got to purchase materials and supplies before you can start any work. This can be a rather large outlay of cash depending on the job. For this reason, PAR requires a 50% deposit on jobs that are $1,000 and over. So this feature works very well with how Paul likes to run his business. Let's go ahead and save our changes. That wraps up the lesson on how to set up your invoices, sales receipts, and estimates in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, just click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online.